Hey everyone, it's Ellie. Welcome back to my channel. I am so excited for today's video. As you guys know, I'm Ellie Talks Money. I teach you guys all about starting your business, scaling it up, ways to create content, build your business credit, and overall just make more money so you can live your best life. So in today's video, I actually want to talk to you about something that's highly requested, and that is how to build your business credit even if you have bad personal credit. Trust me, I am so close to this because I used to have less than a 550 credit score about 16 or 18 months ago. So I definitely know what it's like to have bad personal credit. I know what it's like to be denied for things all the time. Even secured credit cards, I couldn't get them. But business credit is definitely something that saved me. When I learned how to build my business credit, I was able to leverage it to help me get lines of credit over $100,000, business credit cards, so many other opportunities so I could further scale my business even while my personal credit wasn't the best. So if you know that you need this, I want you to go ahead and stay tuned. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, like this video, and comment below what has been your biggest challenge with fixing your personal credit and building business credit so I can make sure to highlight that in my next video. Let's get into it. All right, guys, welcome inside the video. So as promised, today's video is all about building business credit even if you have challenged, struggling personal credit. Trust me, I know what that's like. Now my personal credit is better, but I was at a 550 or less as I about a year and a half ago. So the number one thing that I love about business credit and what you can do to build your business credit even if you have bad personal credit is start building with your tier one trade lines, okay? Everyone write that down. Step one, tier one trade lines. So your tier one trade lines are going to be your net 30 accounts. Net 30 means that these companies are giving you 30 days to pay back whatever you purchase from them. So some great tier one accounts that are not going to ask you for your personal social security number at all and are also going to build your business credit are Uline. Quill is another great company. Crown Office Supplies is a great company. Shirtsy is a great company, and I'll make sure to link these down below. But when you use your EIN, your business name, and your DUNS number to apply for net 30 credit at these companies, when you order something and then actually pay it back early, that's the key, okay? Pro tip, even though they give you 30 days to make your payment, pay it back at day 20 or 25 at most, because paying it early boosts your business credit score a lot. And remember, none of these companies are gonna ask you for your personal social security number. They're going to report straight to your business credit profile to build your score with Dun & Bradstreet, AKA Paydex, Experian, and Equifax, okay? So step one, tier one trade lines, use those and leverage them to then build your score so you can qualify for tier two. Let's get into that right now. Alrighty guys, so we talked about step one, which is building your business credit with tier one vendors. Now I want to tell you how to do this also in step two with tier two vendors, okay? Now, the great thing is, even while your personal credit might be challenged, you still won't need to use your personal credit or have your bad personal credit affect your chances of getting business credit when you're applying for tier two vendors. So this is something I teach all my students through my online courses, but your tier two vendors are going to be places like Staples, Amazon, Sam's Club, your gas cards. These are all actually revolving retail accounts that are going to report to your business credit, but you don't need to have excellent personal credit in order to apply and get approved. So what I love about Staples, that was one of my first retail revolving business credit accounts, is that I was able to get $1,000 on business credit. And even though you may not shop a lot at Staples, what's key is having that report onto your business credit profile. So when you get that approval, approval for $500 or $750 or $1,000, just purchase a couple things: printer paper, pens and pencils, and make sure that you pay back your balance in full in time for your next statement date. This is going to build your business credit, and again, none of these are going to show up on your personal credit score. So even if you have bad personal credit, it's not going to affect your chances of getting approved. Now, when you're applying for business gas cards, depending on how long your business has actually been established, they might ask you to add your social security number onto the application, but I want you to know that they are not going to run a credit check, and it isn't going to affect your personal score. If you have bad personal credit, it's not going to decline you from getting a business gas card. Fuel Man is a great place for this. A to B gas cards is also a great place for this. Chevron is great. One of my first gas cards was actually with BP. And again, I put my social security number for identification. It never ran a check, and it reported to my business credit every single month and really helped to boost my score. So that's what's so amazing about this, is that you are able to continue building with business credit and building up a score that will then help you to qualify for larger lines of credit, to qualify for loans with places like PayPal, Square, etc., working capital without having your bad personal credit hold you back. Because let's face it, as a business owner, we already have enough things to worry about. We already have enough challenges. You do not want to have personal credit be something that holds you back from moving forward. So step two are your tier two trade lines, and I want you to really maximize these, again, because these are revolving accounts. So whether or not you have terrible personal credit, it's not going to affect your ability to build your score here. Let's talk about step three. Guys, so we made it to step three, and here's where it actually gets really good. So I teach my students that your tier three vendors are going to be where you can start getting things like secured business credit cards. What I love about secured business credit cards is that, again, traditional business credit cards, you're going to need to be a personal guarantor, which means you have to fill out a personal credit application in addition to the business application in order to get approved. But with secured business credit cards, and even some unsecured ones, whether or not you have good personal credit isn't going to affect them being able to start you with some business credit. So some of my favorites secured business credit cards, and also unsecured business credit cards that don't require good credit, are Capital One. Discover has a great business credit card. Chase Inc. also has a great business credit card, and then Metro One. Now, what's amazing about Metro One, Capital One, and Discover is that even if you have a less than 600 credit score, I've had students who have a 550 credit score still get approved, but it completely reports to their business credit. So the key thing is, make sure on your application you are also providing your EIN number where it's asked for, and if they do ask you for your DUNS number, make sure you provide that as well. This is what's going to ensure that the reporting goes to your business bureau, all the business bureaus. And the great thing is, you are not going to be held back by having challenged personal credit. The key thing is building from the beginning. Now, why I teach you guys to start with tier one, then tier two, then tier three, is so that by the time you go and apply for some of these secured business credit cards and regular credit cards, they can see that you've already had activity on your business credit report. So they can see that you've paid things back on time in tier one. They can see that you've cleared your balances in tier two. So it adds to your business's reputation and stability, and therefore gives them an opportunity to extend you, even if it's just $500 to begin with. The key thing is to use that, make sure you make your payments on time, and then you can ask for an increase in about 4 to 6 months and get a much higher approval. So that's the game. Pro tip, don't be worried too much about what they give you initially, because you are proving to them that you can handle that much, and showing them that not only can you handle it, but that you can excel with it by paying, making your payments on time, paying your balance in full where you can, so that then when you ask for an increase on your business credits, they will give it to you. All right, so we went over tier one, tier two, tier three. We dropped major gems and pro tips about ways that you can still build your business credit, even if you had bad personal credit. I want you all to know that I was where you are 18 months ago, 520 personal credit score, couldn't even get approved for a secured Discover card at that time in my personal name. But because I built my business credit, I was able to build up my score, get a line of credit, which helped me to build an Airbnb, get a line of credit to help me scale my business with equipment, get a line of credit to help me get another Airbnb. All of these are in my business name. So, like I always tell you guys, if I can do this, you can definitely do this. So again, subscribe to this channel, like this video, and comment below what tier you're at right now. How have you been doing with your business credit? Let me know what questions you have, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Link down below are all my courses and resources. Love y'all. See you soon.